So, welcome on board. Welcome on board on the moon boat journey. So we're going to take off today. We have to start building the boat right now. So we have been talking about several times about the 24 runes of the Elder Futhark. So where's my drum? Okay, one moment. So here on the drum we see the 24 runes, the 24 runes of the Elder Futhark, Fehu, Urus, Turisas, Ansus, Raido, Kaunas, Gebo, Wunjo, and so on. So anyway, we start with folding the runes together to create the rune boat. So we start with the first and the last. And some people say like, you have to use Othala as the last, and others say you have to use Dagas as the last. Some people think that it's a Christian idea to put Dagas in the end. And, you know, it's all theory in the end. It's all theory, and it's some ideas of some people, and then they repeat the same idea all over again. I do believe, you know, we might consider this idea. I like a little bit of mystification. So when we think about the rune masters, let's think about that they are really enlightened masters in a way. You know, I made this painting. I made it more dark blue just the last couple of days. It's nicer now. This sun has like 9 beams, 9 double beams. So 9 worlds, so that's a pretty interesting painting as well. There is, so I'm jumping to another subject. But it is very interesting, like there is this connection between sacred geometry, labyrinths, and this Celtic or Germanic knotwork. There is a real connection there. Anyway, we might want to look for the connection with the runes. So we're talking about Fehu and Dagas right now. We might think about these rune masters like they were like 1,000 years, maybe before that, that they were these enlightened masters who could travel through time. Just think about the idea, just think about that concept. So they might have left some significant knowledge when there are 3 carvings of the 24 runes, and twice you see Othala as the last rune, and once you see the Dagas rune as the last one. So in my mind it's like they left some clues there. They left some clues. They left a door there for us to work with, and that is what we're doing. And so in my inspiration, in my download of information, I am told to work with the Dagas in the end, to fold the boat together. And when you combine the Fehu and the Dagas rune, this is really amazing. So you really have to work on it yourself, you have to meditate on it, and it's just so more and more doors will open for you. Just when you concentrate only on the sound of the runes, well, here we see the Fehu rune and here we see the Dagas rune. Only concentrate on the sound of the runes, that is already very interesting. Fehu, the this sound, when you make it, it's really a very soft almost silent sound, you know, really a soft, so really female as well. So just go back to the basics of sound. I was thinking about it last night, you know, when I'm like at 4 o'clock in the morning, often I'm awake, and that is a very beautiful time to be awake, to think about things in a really deep way, and also spirit connects with us very easily at that time. We have very beautiful insights and understandings. So when you look, I was looking at the 24 runes and the sounds connected with it, and I found out four special runes, like it's the Dagas rune, Dagas, Turisas, Lagus, and Nautis. And why do I think these are really interesting? Because with these four, you need to put your tongue to your, I don't know what it's called. But you have to put it to the top of your mouth. And they say as a development, first the heart is born in the embryo, in the womb of our mother. And the heart has brain cells of its own. When it starts beating, there's no brains developed yet. So the heart has older brains. This is a very interesting thing to think about and meditate on. Because the heart has a deeper and older wisdom, you know, than the mind. And that's true, of course. But it's also an evolutional wisdom that is in the heart. Anyway, when the first thing that is born from the heart is the tongue. So when we connect our tongue with the top of our mouth, we also connect the heart with the brains. In there are Indian meditations, like in Kriya Yoga and other schools, they teach you to, when you meditate, to put your tongue to the top of your mouth. So there is this heart-mind connection. So when you look at Dagas, you need to put your tongue to the top of your mouth. The Nautis, Lagus, and Tivas, Turisas is more like the tongue between the mouth, Turisas. That's pretty interesting too, anyway, if you start thinking about that idea. But the Dagas, Nautis, Lagus, they are like connecting. It's really, it's, you know, when we start talking as a little child, it is pretty, it's pretty clever, you know, if you concentrate on these sounds that you make, like t and d, how subtle, l, these little different moves you make with your mouth. So it's something to really work on and think about as well when we work with runes, go to the basics, the very basics of sound. So runes, we can talk about Viking Age runes. There's 16 Viking Age runes, and I like to work with the elder runes. There are bones from China in carvings. You can recognize runes in there. There's cave paintings or carvings, and you can recognize runes. And there's also a Celtic there's something from Bronze Age found from Spain, that area that they have also, like, there it's a Celtic language, written language with runes. There's some runes in there, you can recognize it as runes. So runes are really way old, and they, you know, just working with them, it's opening doors for us. And Fehu, you should really work on these runes every day. You have to live with them, you have to walk with them, and that is makes so much, it's so interesting. So when you think about Fehu, the first rune, anyway, first Fehu, female, very interesting, all this F sound. So Fehu, Freya. This is also a key. You can look at it at the key. And then when we go on our rune journey, we will put it into the lock. And you see here is the lock. So when you put this together, you put the Fehu rune in the door, and the door will open up. Okay, well, please, when you when you go on this rune journey, you know, you have to open your own door, you know. That is, I will just open a door for you, but you have to walk in there, you know, like the old shamans, the ancient shamans, they open the door. They open the door. So in this way, this is what I'm doing for you. I'm opening this door. I feel this feel, another world with this F sound, the Fehu. So feel. I feel these runes around me, the Fehu and the Dagas. And like on this rune boat journey, the first time we took off, we did like every day we made a new combination. We're not going to work like it on this time. So please watch this video. So this is the very start of the rune boat journey. And please make a drawing. And you can do it with just a pen and make your own connection of these two runes, because before I made a different painting of the Fehu rune and the Dagas, and I made like the Dagas, and then I had the Fehu going right through the middle of the Dagas. Yeah, this is the Dagas, you had the Fehu right going through the middle, like, and then just add one little, then already you can find the Fehu in there. So I just made this combination on this stone. Can you see it? Yes, now you can see it. So this is also a combination of Fehu and Dagas in a way. You know, this looks like a key as well. Anyway, a keystone. And here's another combination that I made of the Fehu and the Dagas. And might look a little bit like a butterfly or whatever, you know, like, but you know, that is so. Please make your own combination of the Fehu and the Dagas rune. So this is where this time our journey takes off. We can start in the middle of the boat and make the combination of the Eiwas and the Jera rune. So now you have to find out, I won't show you now the Jera and the Eiwas, you have to look for it yourself. Anyway, when you start, this combination, for me, it talks about initiation. It talks about initiation. So we can start the rune boat journey like the last time we did. We started with the initiation of Freyr, the nine nights of Freyr, the nine nights of initiation. But this time we do it from another angle. So we start with Fehu and Dagas. And Fehu, wow man, I love this rune. The more you think about it, the more you feel about, the more it starts to talk to you, the more it starts to move in your energy field. And Dagas, bam man, bam, it opens this door. Fehu Dagas, so this female key will open, bam, the door of Dagas. And the combination, you know, earlier I made like more a kind of a mental interpretation of these two, you know, and it has to move our energy fields and it becomes more interesting all the time. So I am developing this kind of rune boat journey qigong exercise, and I do it every day, really, you know. I go to the four directions and I visualize the runes to the four directions and I make these movements, and then I move to the other direction, to the upper world, the underworld, and connect, you know, bring the runes inside of me, in my energy field, and all these symbols and these powers behind these symbols. And so this is what I'm doing every day, and I would love to teach you. So well, next Thursday. Next Thursday. So it's not tomorrow, but next Thursday we will have our first Rune Boat Journey Zoom meeting. And I hope to have made the next connection, the Otala. Oh, I'm not going to talk about that yet. We're talking about Fehu Dagas now, and I really want you to take your time for this combination, the Fehu and this Dagas, because it will open the door. It will open the door, and we move in this first part of this Rune Boat Journey. We move towards the initiation, our initiation this time. So this is the first part of the Rune Boat Journey, combining the 24 runes and create the boat. So we will have 12 combinations of runes, and we will take our time for this. We will take our time. So we're not going to do it every day. It's much too much work. 24 runes, we create 12 combinations, and we start with Fehu and Dagas. So earlier, my interpretation of this combination is like Fehu, it talks about our possessions. It also told me in the first place, the Fehu rune told me in the first place to allow myself to have possessions, you know, like when you are more like a poor kind of person, you like to share all you have with others because you are all poor, and that is really beautiful. But once you have a little bit of money or a little bit more of money, you cannot give it all away all the time. You have to take care of it because, yeah, you know, also when you grow older, you have to take care of yourself and your family and your friends and loved ones. But you have to draw some lines somewhere. You know? So maybe those lines can be runes. Anyway, it's about, for me, it taught me to allow myself to have some possessions. So Fehu, it means kettle. And so it allows us, but it's also a responsibility to look after your possessions. And Dagas is really the rune of bam, breakthrough. And the day, and of course, it's F and the. Yeah, it's funny. You can also talk the with the tongue between your lips as well. You can use the in your with the tongue to the top of your mouth, the, and you can also the. You can also make it with the between the lips. Okay, Dagas, Fehu. So now we use this Fehu, this female Fehu, to open the Dagas door for us, you know. So we are moving. I can see I can see this in my, you know, you see my arm here. If you continue this line to there and this line to there, you have the Dagas rune. Anyway, so we open this door. Today we open this Fehu. With the Fehu key, we open the Dagas door. And here we will move forward. We will move to the future. Wow, forward, future. It's all this Fehu, this F sound. This female F sound of Fehu. Very interesting. Door, Dagas, door, day. So do. Do. So make your drawings, the drawing. So yeah, that's all nice. So please make this drawing, get the tattoo. you know, if you want me to make a tattoo on your body, you know, tell me and then I will start learning how to do it, because somebody wants to learn me, to help me find out. So anyway, and if you like to order one of my paintings, that's wonderful too. So that's a way to, and also like when you connect with me next Thursday for the Zoom meeting, that's another way of of tributing to this rune boat journey. Anyway, this is really powerful, and well, anyway, you know, just please start walking with these runes. They will open doors, they will show you. Anyway, I think that's enough for today. 20 minutes of rune talk. You know, I sent you all the blessings and all the love, and thank you for watching. And till next time. And I'm not going to promise when I'm going to make the next step, because we're going to work on with two other runes next time. The Urus and the Otala rune. This is also a beautiful combination of runes. But now, Fehu Dagas, walk with these runes the next at least 4 days. Blessings.